Welcome to day two of Rocking the Daisies, and we have parked like we thought last night was far. Now it's ridiculous. Check out the view. So they really ask all their food vendors to use like recyclable items and boxes and knives and forks, and then when you finish with your food you can also chuck it away and they can recycle and all of that sort of thing. Dumps in the camps. Very good, Rocking the Daisies. Are the people paying attention? Plastic. Ah, it's been cleared out already. Yes, this is what we like, keeping things tidy. Well, I was just going to show you how cool it is that you can recycle in your campsite. Never mind that it's already been cleaned up. Good job, Daisy team.
All the disposable boxes.
Good one, Rocking the Dizzle. So we're cruising down to the main stage now because Beardy Man's playing and we're really interested in hearing his beats live because Mr. John loves him. Hey, Mr. John. That means yes, the Mr. John language.
Even in your eyes.
video on and I was like, whoa, we're so much further away than we were yesterday. I was not kidding. We are literally the furthest row of cars out of the whole festival. Can you turn the lights on again? We are literally the furthest row of cars out of the whole festival. No one parked us in. Oh, so we've got as far as we possibly could go. Look, for you guys living overseas, this is nothing. Like, you're used to Glastonbury and Coachella where there's like hundreds of thousands of people. But this is a developing market in South Africa, and Rocking the Daisies has done a super amazing job this year. The production's been really, really good. Super, super well done. All the medical staff were there, all the security was on board. Food was good, sound was great. Last night the wind kind of ruined it a little bit because it's like blow the sound away. Tonight the wind's been far better and you could hear amazingly well and everything. So if you come to South Africa and you end up South Africa in the month of October, it's always the first weekend in October, and it's a great festival to come to because you've got a good kind of cross-section of everything. You can watch South African hip-hop, you can watch South African like trap and glitch up, and you can watch South African pop music, rock music, electronic music. So it's a really, really nice mixture of everything, and it's beautiful to be out here in Darling where it's loads of fun. I'm gonna say goodbye for now and I will catch you in my next video. As ever, thank you so much for watching. If you guys have any questions about South Africa or South African music or festivals or whatever, please put it in the comment section below and I'll try to give you the information. So, talking about how green Rocking the Daisies is, point one, the national bird hasn't flown away. I think it's a good start.